This is the video to go with Section 23 of Hansen and Quinn's Greek and Intensive course, and it covers the aorist indicative active of thematic verbs that end in omega. You can refer to Hansen and Quinn on pages 48 and 49 for this material, and also the appendix on page 658. The aorist indicative active is past time and simple aspect, and to form it, you need the principal part 3 stem and the endings. You may be thinking, we're doing the indicative, and this is past time, so don't we need the past indicative augment? Well, let's look at the principal parts of luo. Luo, luso, elusa, leluca, lelumai, eluthein. And let's look at that third one. It already has the augment attached, and so for the indicative, all we have to do is take off the alpha at the end. We keep the augment because we're doing the indicative. In other non-indicative forms that use the third principal part, we'd have to take off the epsilon for non-indicative uses, but we're not doing that right now. Now we need the endings and a chart to put them in, singular and plural, first, second, and third person. Here are the endings of the singular, a, as, e, and the third singular can also have a new movable. And here are the endings in the plural, amen, ate, an. Accent is recessive. And the default translation is she verbed, which is past time and simple aspect. Notice that although these are new endings, you can see some familiar things about them. The second person singular has the same person marker, that sigma, as the earlier tenses that you've learned. The third person singular is the same as the imperfect third person singular ending. The person markers for first and second person plural are men and te, just as in all of the other tenses you've learned so far. And the new at the end of the third person plural is even the same as the new at the end of the third person plural of the imperfect, on, just a different vowel in front of it. So, although this is a new set of endings, some of it should be familiar enough for it to be starting to organize itself in your mind and not be too hard to memorize. Let's put it together. So, keeping the augment, we need the third principal part, the endings, and recessive accent, and this chart to put it in. So, third principal part, and here, with its augment still on it, is the third principal part of luo in all of the persons and numbers. Now we need the endings. And here's what happens. A, as, e, or en, amen, ate, an. Now we're going to do recessive accent on all of those nice verbs. Remember that all we need to do is look at the last syllable and see if it's long or short to decide where to put the accent. So, elusa, that's a short alpha, and so we go 1, 2, 3, and put the accent on the third to last. Short, 1, 2, 3, accent on the third to last. Short, 1, 2, 3, accent on the third to last. In the plural, that men is short, so we go 1, 2, 3, and the accent is still on the third to last, although this time it's over the upsilon instead of on the epsilon augment. Same happens in the second person plural. Short, 1, 2, 3, acute over the upsilon. And finally, that's a short alpha in that ending. So count 1, 2, 3, and the accent goes over the epsilon augment. That's the whole conjugation. So we get elusa, I freed, elusas, you freed, elusen, she freed, or elusa, elusamen, we freed, elusate, y'all freed, and elusan, they freed. Let's try it with another verb. Here's our friend, paideuo, with its six principal parts. Paideuo, paideuso, epaideusa, pepaideuka, pepaideumai, epaideuthein. We go to the third principal part, and keeping the augment, we use the stem, which we get by taking the alpha off of the end of the principal part. We add the ending, and we put in the recessive accent. So, epaideusa, I educated. Epaideusas, you educated. Third principal part stem, ending. Epaideusa, she educated. Epaideusamen, we educated. Augment, stem, ending, accent, epaideusate, y'all educated. And finally, epaideusan, they educated. That should give you enough to work with to apply your knowledge of the aorist indicative active to other verbs and be ready for drills, classwork, and translation.